Now, after going global, it's time to go rural. And this company is in one of the very few companies in the SME space which is into agri, which is into the rural space. In fact, I couldn't find any other company which was doing a comparable thing. And this is into agri supply management. May I request Prime Customer Services?
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for the opportunity. Let me just quickly give you a brief background of our company. Prime Customer Services was started in 2007 April. The objective of the company initially was to supply fruits and vegetables to various households and modern trade. We started with our design van, and we used to go to different societies and take approvals. About within 3 to 6 months of operations, we realized that maybe home delivery is too early in those point of time. So we quickly realized that it is important to change the business model wherein you become a kind of a supplier and service provider to modern trades and corporates. So as we stand today, our company is primarily into two segments of business. One is purely a service business, which is sorting, grading, packing, warehousing, clearing, forwarding, facility management, productivity contracts. Within that, our core clients are Wagh Bakri Tea, Reliance Fresh. We handle almost 70 to 110 per day of fruits and vegetables and dairy and bakery products for Reliance for last 11 years. When we started, it was 8 ton per day. Today, we go up to even 120 ton per day. So in service business, it is typically cost plus plus, markup model, productivity-based, project-based contracts, which are renewed every year. Our core business, the second part of the segment of the business, is fruit vegetable supply chain business. Now, within fruit vegetable supply chain business, if I were to simplify the business, it is purely sourcing and distribution of fruits and vegetables. When we source from farmers, we source from local area aggregators, we source from mandis also, and we do enter into agreements with small and marginal farmers, large farmers for some sort of a lease farming, joint venture farming, though it is a very small portion of the overall business. When I talk to a distribution, basically we have identified a couple of segments. So if you see the industry, it is still about 90% plus unorganized. So you still need to be dealing in mandis. And we have got a relationship and association in about 50 APMCs across country. So when I talk of distribution, we sell it to different mandis. We supply to modern trade. We supply to food processing companies. We do supply to exporters. This year onwards, we have started our own exports. So we will be exporting mixed vegetables, pomegranate, mango. We also have a couple of general trade clients wherein they in turn are a distributor or a reseller, or they have their own shops. Some of them are cart pullers. So broadly, the distribution is divided into multiple segments as the industry is operating. Give you a background now, we operate in about 40 districts of Maharashtra, Gujarat, Rajasthan, and couple of districts in North India, Himachal and all. Our primary categories are pomegranate, mango, onion, tomatoes. We are also building two new categories, which is grapes and orange. Now let me take you through the presentation. It just connects, you know, I thought, let me just, yeah. So as the, you know, industry, we are basically into agro. Within agro, we are into horticulture, fruits and vegetable segment. Our revenue last year in FY19 from fruits vegetable was about 37 crore and service business was about 6 crore. Over the last 5 years, we have grown our revenue at 22% CAGR. Our EBITDA has grown at 33%. We have got about 600 B2B clients and about 40,000 customers in B2C in Ahmedabad and Bombay. Our vision is to basically create an institution and, you know, kind of a company which is, you know, fully integrated into fruit vegetable supply chain business. So when I say fully integrated, means you are from farm to consumer. There are various activities being performed, right from pre-harvesting, post-harvesting, logistics, branding and distribution, as I said, to multiple segments. Our mission is to, basically increase our clients and shareholders and employees' wealth. We work with a lot of farmers. We work with more than 25,000 farmers in these 40 districts. So our commitment is to basically provide hygienic, high quality, well packed fruits and vegetables. I would just like to touch upon one point, like 20, 25, 30 years back, if you see many categories like edible oil, hair oil, salt, milk, masalas, they were all unorganized. There was no branding, packing, MRP, logistics, no planning. I think fruit vegetable trade is somewhere there today it stands. We see that in the next 5 to 10 years, there will be massive change the way the trade is getting operated and you know how market participants are operating in this business. So company overview, basically our team, the core team has got more than 3 decades of experience. Chairman has got about 23 years of experience. His prior background was FMCG sales distribution. He has worked with Marico Industries, Subixa Retail, and a couple of other FMCG companies. When we started in 2007, last he was with Subixa Retail and he was heading Gujarat operations for fruits, vegetables. We also have a couple of independent directors who have worked in various agri-input companies, food processing companies for more than 25, 30 years. So they all bring in a very rich experience of, you know, huge network with, you know, various segment of our business like, you know, APMCs, farmers, agri-input companies. Myself, being a founding shareholder and whole-time director, have got more than 20 years of experience in financial capital market and have been involved in the company since 2013-14 more actively, and recently since 2016 I have been taking care of Maharashtra expansion, exports business building, and tying up with food processing companies, and also identifying couple of areas where certain food processing plants are closed, which can be kind of acquired on a long lease, and we can you know create a scale in the business. Yeah, so you know, when we say meeting customers' requirements in F&B segment, it looks generic, but it's very dynamic industry. For example, a client sitting in Mumbai who is wanting to export a mango from Mumbai airport has a different requirement of a material, at what level it should be harvested, how it should be packed, what kind of treatment need to be done. Similarly, when you deal with modern trade like Reliance, Big Bazaar, Hypercity, Star Bazaar, Big Basket, their requirement of quality, packing, the ripening stage of the fruits are very different. When you export to Middle East, again the packing, the qualities differ. So it's a very important critical part that how do you harvest a product, how do you do the sorting, grading and packing of the product, and how do you deliver it. A core competency is basically, as I said, it is mango, pomegranate, banana, grapes and onion. Banana, we also set up a cold storage and the ripening chamber in 2011, and we were working with India's largest banana player, Desai Agro. Later on it was acquired by Deepak Fertilizer. We have, as I mentioned, we have a network of more than 25,000 farmers across these 40 districts we work. We have tie up with more than 50 APMCs. We have local area aggregators more than 300. Yeah, so as I mentioned, the sourcing plan and you know sorting, grading are a very critical component of the industry, because your each client is different, his requirement is different, there is a lot of planning which happens. Yeah, so we have a very long standing relationship in this industry for more than 12 years with modern trade, a couple of exporters, food processing companies. So our value proposition is, of course, first of all, it's sourcing, the reach which you have, the kind of processes you follow, right, kind of you know processes you follow for harvesting, you guide the farmer, handhold them. We our network in pomegranate and mango has increased to more than 37,500 acres in Maharashtra, Gujarat and Rajasthan, where we procure pomegranate from. We procure mango from Maharashtra and Gujarat from more than 12,000 acre area. We have discussed, these are the numbers for you know for pomegranate and mango, 7,500 and 4,000 farmer network. Yeah, so we adhere to international standards by associating with various third party logistic providers and various third party warehouses and cold storages. We ensure that the right process is followed, of the material is particularly graded, sorted and handled and cleaned, right. This is our basically graph of you know areas where we work. Primarily, our large part of sourcing happens through Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Maharashtra. This places and the town and the districts are available in our presentation loaded on the website and the BSA as well. So I'm not discussing the each name of, right? Yeah, so. So I think we have discussed this, what we do, sourcing, sorting, grading, packing, ripening of fruits, packing, etc. Prime Fresh is our brand, which we have been building since 2014. This brand is for B2B and B2C also. So for example, in North and Northeast, when we supply pomegranate from Maharashtra, Rajasthan and Gujarat, there is a wholesale 10 kg pack where the brand is there. So most of the players now we have reached that even at times material is not available with they say that you do the packing in your box, because when people buy, they don't open, because Prime Fresh has that, build that credibility that yours, that your grading and packing is good and your material inside is always, kind of up to the standards. So this category, Prime Fresh brand, we are building primarily with mango, and now this year we're going to extend it to apple and orange and other categories. Fresh at Home was a brand which was the early brand when we started the company, because the objective was to deliver to the households. These are list of our clients. So this is basically a chart where it discusses which material is available during which month in which state, and what is the lean and the peak season. Again, these details are available, so I'm not going deep into it. Yeah, these are the numbers, how we have grown our farmer reach, our APMC reach, and our consolidators who deal with us. This business eventually will scale up with the help of three important initiatives. Each company who want to create a big scale in the game will have to set up collection centers, distribution centers, and the pack houses. The pack house is nothing but a very integrated hygiene facility, wherein there is from arrival to dispatch, there are certain standards followed, there are separate sorting grading areas, there are storage areas, there is pre-cooling chambers, there is ripening chambers, there are different kind of packing lines. So pack houses will serve as a facility for domestic and export market. Collection center typically are being set up close to the farm. For example, Nasik is a very big belt for, let's say, pomegranate or a grapes or an onion. So generally you go to a very prominent agri belt and you set up these collection centers, wherein you ensure that a farmer can come and deliver and they can get paid immediately. So we have seasonal collection centers, and now we are also setting up some of the permanent collection centers. So generally seasonal collection centers are being set up where the material availability is between 3 to 4 months, and the annual capacity where you can run the center for 8 months, we set up a dedicated full-time collection center. Generally our internal benchmark is that each collection center should give you a minimum material of about 10 to 15 ton per day. So as I discussed, we are adding a couple of new categories, grapes and orange, apart from the other categories we discussed, mango, pomegranate, apple, tomatoes and onion. We were predominantly Gujarat and Maharashtra based company 2.5 years back. In the last 2.5 years, we are going to North and Northeast, and we are tying up with large, well-established players. We are also tying up with modern trade in Delhi and other areas. And we believe that a lot of material from Gujarat, Maharashtra and Rajasthan flows to Northeast. This trade typically depends a lot on how efficient you are on your logistic and how efficient you are on reaching where the material is not available. For example, pomegranate, onion, tomato, etc. is not available in North and Northeast. Even banana, for example, Punjab, Haryana buys a lot from Gujarat and Maharashtra. So your understanding of which particular category is grown, available in which season, where, and where it moves is extremely important to scale up the trade. Generally, this trade, as I said, being unorganized, largely run by local area entrepreneurs. So there are very few national companies who can say that I can supply, for example, pomegranate round the year, 8 months across country, right? So there are very few players who will say I can supply you a mango from Maharashtra also and Gujarat also. right? What we are doing is that we are trying to create a scale through creating a reach both at the back end and the front end. So horticulture production is about 30 crore ton. Even if you, with the last 2 years of high inflation in the fruit vegetable prices, if you take even 30-40 rupees a kg, I think the industry size is more than 7 lakh crore. Out of that, only I think 10%, 12% is organized, including modern trade, food processing companies, and exporters, and a couple of players like us. So there is a huge scope that this industry should, get organized. We believe that at least 40% of the business will be organized in the next 7 to 8 years. And that offers a huge opportunity for at least 30-40 companies like ours in the country. I think globally this business, if you see most organized players, their sizes are between 2,000 crore to 15,000 crore. So it's very much possible that in the next 7-8 years you will have many fruit vegetable companies in India with a size of at least 1,000 to 5,000 crore. Financials, second half last year, FY19. This is basically a presentation prepared by Carvi also, so they have included this half yearly comparison. So our top line was up 29%, and primarily it was increase in volume in pomegranate. Depreciation and all other figures are discussed. I think these are available on website. Growth catalyst, very important. So as I said, this industry eventually will have to work on these three initiatives to bring the scale in the game. As I said, collection centers, distribution centers, and pack houses. Pack houses are must if you want to tie up with global retailers, global wholesalers, and if you want to have a good order book getting built. So these pack houses, we have identified Kutch, Nasik, and one or two other areas near Baramati in Maharashtra where we can set up these pack houses. And based on that pack houses, you can basically get large orders, long-term orders. Today, a large part of business is done on a daily basis. A lot of negotiations happen. These are B2B transactions. But as you create that strong backward integration and capacity in infrastructure, you can get a lot of long-term orders, and you can also start getting advances from them. Yeah, so the second growth driver for us is going to be exports. In the last 3 to 5 years, we have supplied to various exporters. We have also been doing our own exports to Middle East, UK, Netherlands, and we have built a clear understanding of how the trade happens there, what kind of packing standards are there, quality standards are there, and we have identified about 100 clients in UK, Netherlands, Middle East, and Far East. We are very actively in touch with them. We expect that our exports, which was hardly there last year, should be at least 6 to 7 crore in FY20. Our vision is to build a 60 crore export vertical in the next 4 years. Yeah, so I think in any business, three things are very important: the volume, the cost, and the price. So we believe that exports will give volumes, B2C will give you a good price, and backward integration by tying up with farmers or doing some sort of a farming, you can cut your cost. So today this trade operates on a very low margin. Generally the gross margins ranges between 6 to 13% depending on the client. So in mango, for example, modern trade, you earn 13%, but in APMC trade, in pomegranate, you earn only 5 to 6%. So this, there is a wide range, this GP range, and the net profit margins again ranges between 2 to 4%. So if you want to migrate to, let's say 15 to 20% on the gross margin, and if you want to have a, let's say, 4.5 to 7.5% net profit margin, then I think these three initiatives, the exports, the backward integration, farming, and B2C will help a lot. Also, having a small turnover of 44 crore last year, your compliance cost, your investment in farmer acquisitions, your investment in traveling, and other brand initiatives are restricting the margins currently. So we believe that our corporate overheads and the fixed operating overheads will kind of move very low on as a percentage of sales as we grow. So last year we did about 10,800 tons of fruits, vegetables selling. Service would be very big number because we earn only certain paisa per kg when we do provide service. So we don't book the turnover, we book only that service margin. So our bandwidth today in this 40 districts is about 1 lakh tons of procurement, which we have built over the last 5 to 8 years. So you can see that from 10,800 ton to 1 lakh ton procurement bandwidth. And this procurement bandwidth keeps rising as we speak every month. So our team keeps traveling, keeps meeting. This farmer relationship built over the years also now, you know, kind of translating into, word of mouth. And we think that in the next 2 to 3 years, we should have a 2 lakh tons of procurement bandwidth. Generally, this industry, because of high negotiations and all, last line. So this industry generally will have a 30-35% strike rate when you convert your capacity of procurement to business. Thank you so much. I think we can take the questions.
Very interesting, very different. Urmil Shah from IDBI Capital. Sir, can I request you?